growing up as a young musician, there were a few places one would dream about. And Carnegie Hall most certainly was that one place. There have been such magical moments of communication, which are unforgettable for the people who have been present at these concerts, as well as for the artists who have been on stage. And I think that's the mystery of Carnegie Hall. You know, coming to Carnegie Hall with the Berlin Philharmonic Orchestra and the Bruch Concerto and Sir Simon Rattle is obviously a very important moment in my life, because that orchestra is linked so much with the beginnings of my musical life, with Carrion obviously. But I have never traveled to America with the Berlin Philharmonic Orchestra, and it somehow feels particularly festive and wonderful. The importance of expanding repertoire can't really be pointed out enough. There will be premieres by Penderecki, a solo piece, which he has written, actually the first solo piece I'm premiering in my entire life. And then there's the second sonata of Previn. There is a beautiful piece by Moret, which I premiered precisely 25 years ago. And it goes fabulously well with the Berg Concerto. For me, the Berg Violin Concerto is the greatest contemporary piece written in the last century. And then coupling it with Moret, that together will give the audience, the Moret and the Berg, a very unique insight into how poetic and also how almost romantic, in the best sense of the way, and I mean that in the very emotional sense, contemporary music can be. So the Mutters Virtuosi, which is my little orchestra, the string ensemble consists of actual and former students, scholars of my foundation. We celebrated our 15th anniversary this year. Bringing them to Carnegie Hall, of course, is particularly exciting because there's this bond, you know, which reaches throughout the world. These are goodwill ambassadors, actually. Music is such a wonderful language who embraces all of us. Of course, in such a wonderful surrounding as Carnegie Hall, you also want to play a trio program. So piano trio with two pieces which are probably the prime of the repertoire, the Archduke Rudolf, who had such a prominent place in Beethoven's life. And then Tchaikovsky's trio, which came after the death of his friend Nikolai Rubinstein. And it deals with some of their favorite Russian folk songs and, you know, variations over that. So yes, chamber music for a violinist is really the core, if you are serious. And some of the string trios I will play during these wonderful evenings at Carnegie Hall.